Hello students, this is the second video on boilers. In the first video, we discussed about what is a boiler, what are the types of the boiler, and what are the factors to be considered while selecting a boiler, and what are the properties of a good boiler. And after that, we discussed about Cornish boiler. So, Cornish boiler is a 5-tube boiler. Now, we will discuss about second 5-tube boiler. This is the Lancashire boiler. So now we can see here, we have three views here. It is actually in third angle projection. Here you can see, this is the front view, and this is the side view, and this is the top view. Right? So you can see here, there are two fire tubes are there. You can see this is one first tube, this is second tube. In top view, we are able to see two tubes, but in front view, we can see only one tube. Means these two tubes are side by side. But you can see in the side view, two tubes. You can see one circle over here, one more circle over here. Right? So means it consists of two large fire tubes. One fire tube, second fire tube. Right? It is internally fired. So it is internally fired. Natural circulation means the water is flowing naturally due to gravity. And natural draught fire tube boiler. Natural circulation and natural draught means there is no equipment for the exhaust gases, right? Normally through the chimney, they are escaping to the atmosphere. Now, coming to the parts, if you see, as I told, there are two large fire tubes, one over here, second over here, and for each fire tube, there will be a grate at the starting. Means we are, so we can see here, there will be a grate here. Over the grate, we are going to burn coal in the presence of air. Right? So after the grate, there is a fire brick lining. You can see here, there is a fire brick lining. So the main use of this fire brick lining is, it is due to this, the coal or ash will not enter into the tubes. At the same time, it will deflect the flue gases upward direction. Got it? The main use of this fire brick bridge is, it won't allow the ash or coal into the fire tube. At the same time, it will deflect the flue gases upward direction. Again, if you see the cross section of this tube, it is conical towards the air. Means the area is decreasing from here to here. Meaning that if the area decreases, what happens to velocity? Velocity will increase. Therefore, it accelerates the flow of the flue gases. Okay. So, the flue gases will start from the grate and it will move towards the forward direction. Again, through the downward channel, it will go to the bottom flue. From the bottom flue, you can see the cursor in the video. From the bottom flue, again the flue gases are passing through the front. Again, after that, from the side flue, you can come to the front top view. Now, usually, starting from grate to one end, again from the bottom flue, they are coming to the far front. Again from the side flue, the flue gases are moving right side. Total how many passes here? Total three passes. One is the main flue. Main flue is from grate to one end. Again bottom flue, second pass. Third pass is the side flue. So at the end of the side channel, there are two dampers you can see. This is first damper. This is second damper. So the main purpose of dampers are to regulate the air flow. From these dampers, the flue gases are escaped to the atmosphere. From these dampers, the flue gases are escaped to the atmosphere. Now you can see, it is a 5-tube boiler. The flue gases are flowing inside the tube. Surrounding, what is this one? This is the water. So therefore, due to the heat exchange, as I discussed, there are two modes of air heat exchanging takes place in this case of boilers. So one is the conduction as well as the convection. Due to this, the water will be converted into the steam. As I discussed, every boiler will consist of mountings as well as the accessories. So, mountings are for safety purpose, accessories for increasing the efficiency of the boiler. Now, here also you have so many mountings you can see. Safety valve, steam stop valve, manhole, low water, high steam safety valve, and there is a door. Right? Again, you have feed check valve, pressure gauge, and you can see this is the blow-off cock. So the main, as I discussed, the blow-off cock is used to empty the boiler, at the same time to remove the dust particle or foreign particle mud present inside the boiler. Okay, pressure gauge reads the pressure of the steam generated inside the boiler. This safety valve will be to safeguard the system under high pressures. From this steam stop valve, we can make use of the steam. The manhole is, it allows the person to enter inside the boiler for any inspection purpose. So this low water high steam valve will it will alert the system when the water is low. Okay, so these are the main parts as well as the working of the Lancashire boiler. We can see here, so there will be a fire brick lining. Always for any boiler, fire brick lining will be there. The main advantage of fire brick lining is it will take the heat to the atmosphere or surroundings. Okay. Now we can see the 3D diagram of this Lancashire boiler. You can see this is the side view. As you've seen in the previous diagram, inside you, you can see two fire tubes. This is one fire tube. This is second fire tube. And you can see he is feeding the coal into the grate. You can see fire also. Right? This is the grate. And the grate is the perforated one. Now we can see here ash is collected. Ash is deposited at the bottom. And this reads the pressure inside the boiler. So you can see the size of the boiler also. Okay. Now, here same figure. So this is the opening for the grate. Okay. So two fire tubes are there. Same over here. Here pumps are there to pump the water. Reciprocating pumps are there. Okay. So this is about Lancashire boiler. This is the second fire tube boiler what we discussed.
This is the third fire tube boiler. So it's locomotive boiler. Here you can see the cut section of the locomotive boiler. Here you can see n number of tubes. So these are all fire tubes. So in these tubes, the flue gases are moving from one end to another end, and these tubes are covered with water. So over this way we have water, and here we have a grate. Over the grate, we are firing coal. Thereby, the hot flue gases are liberated. Those flue gases are passing through the tubes from this end to this end. Again, here it is only one pass from this end to this end. After this, they will escape through the chimney to the atmosphere. Okay? So, while the flue gases are passing through the tubes, they will exchange the heat with the tubes. Thereby, the tubes will be heated. And these tubes will exchange heat with the surrounding water. Thereby, the water is converted into the steam. Now, if you see the diagram, right. So you can see here, this is the grate over which, a 2D diagram, over which we are burning the coal. Okay. Here you can see, this is the, we can say, the damper or arch. It is used to deflect the flue gases upward direction. At the same time, it will prevent the entering of ash into the fire tubes. You can see, these are the fire tubes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fire tubes are here, right? 6, total 6 fire tubes are here. Over this, the flue gases are moving from here to here. So, this arrow shows the direction of the motion of the flue gases. These flue gases are moving from right to left, and here from the left, they will escape to the atmosphere through the chimney. Okay. Now, we can see here, this dotted line is the water line. Okay. Now, we can see one more thing here, 1, 2, 3 tubes are there. Here the name is superheater. So, superheater is the accessory. So, as we know, accessories are for improving the efficiency. Mountings are for the safety. So, superheater is the accessory. It is used to increase the efficiency of the boiler. So, what is the main use of superheater, sir? Usually, that's always steam under high pressure and high temperature is useful. Means it will do more work. Okay. So, normally the steam generated is saturated steam. If you superheat the steam, then only that will produce more amount of work. To increase the, what we call, steam drainage fraction, we can say. To increase the drainage fraction of the steam, we are using superheater, so that it will become superheated steam. Saturated steam is converted into superheated steam through the superheater. Right? So, you can see, from this, if you want to make use of the steam, that steam is passing through the superheater, then from that, from the steam dome, we are making use of the steam. And flue gases are escaping through the chimney, and these are the safety valve, visible, lever, so water gauge, fire hole to feed the grate, okay, damper to regulate the flow of the air. These are the fire tubes, okay, exhaust steam pipe, right. Now you can see here with the color diagram. So this is the grate, this is the fire break arch to deflect the flue gases and to avoid the entering of the ash into the boiler. So here you can see these red colored one. So this is the superheated tubes. You can see superheated steam is denoted with red color, saturated steam is denoted with green color. Usually the steam produced by extracting the heat from the hot flue gases is in the green color. If you want to make use of the steam, that steam is passed through the superheated tubes, thereby it is converted into superheated steam, that is denoted by red color. Here, after passing through the superheater, then only it is expanded inside the piston cylinder assembly. Okay. Now, so you can see the parts, mountings are there here, safety valves are there, firebox, fire hole, okay, regulator valve, dome, these are all mountings. Okay. Accessory extra here is the superheater. Okay. Now, I will show you video how it will work. If you see here, so here grate is there, these are the flue gases, these flue gases are passing through the tubes, okay. So this blue color one is the water, this blue color one is the water. So again these, this thick blue color is the water, this light blue color is the steam usually, okay. So this light blue color is passing through the superheater before making use of. You can see once the steam, saturated steam is passing through the superheater, it is converted into superheated steam, that is shown in the red color. Now you can see here that steam is expanded inside the cylinder, right. So it is the double acting one, you can see left side and right side, two sides it is expanding. After expanding, its quality is decreasing, thereby it is converted into saturated steam and some partly water also, right. That steam is escaped through the atmosphere. You can see here through the coupling rod, the wheels are rotating. So this is about the locomotive boiler. It is the artificial draught. It is not natural draught. It is artificial draught, natural circulation, fire tube boiler. Okay. This is, with this, fire tube boilers are completed according to the syllabus.